All right, guys, we are back in my garage for another video. And as you can see, the hoodie is out, which means two things are true. One is it's getting cold outside, so it's that time of the year where I begin to regret making all of my videos in my garage. And two, it's getting cold outside, so that means a lot of B58 owners are going to be asking, is this smoke normal or is this something that I should be worried about? And I get it. It's probably not something that you've paid a lot of attention to in the past, but after reading horror stories about PCV issues and valve cover problems, if you see smoke from your car, there's always a question of, is that oil or something that is indicating a bigger problem is happening? Or is it just normal for something that cars experience during this time of year? So I want to explain to you guys the different reasons why your car might be smoking, which 99.99% of you are not having a problem. I can pretty much guarantee it. And this will hopefully put your mind at ease so you understand exactly what you're experiencing. So let's go ahead and talk about it. And hopefully you guys find this video useful. Now, as always, for everybody that's new to the channel, I create these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in our community, as well as discuss technical topics so that we have a better understanding of how our engines work. So if you're interested in more videos like that, be sure to subscribe because there will be a lot more coming out in the future. So there are several different reasons why you might see smoke come out of your exhaust, and we're going to kind of categorize them into good and bad, even though there isn't really good smoke, but maybe we can just say normal or smoke that you don't really need to worry about. So starting off with good smoke or normal smoke is water. And this is the one, again, that 99.9% of you are experiencing and probably seeing around this time of year. And it is very normal for a couple different reasons. The main one is that the combustion process that's happening in your engine creates water. It is a natural byproduct of the chemical reaction when fuel is burning inside of your combustion chamber. So if you look at the chemical equation for all of it, basically what you're doing is adding oxygen to your fuel. And when that burns, the chemical reaction produces water and carbon dioxide. So that's what's going to be coming out of your exhaust. So anytime your car is running, it's creating water vapor, it's creating H2O, and you're going to see that, especially in the colder months. Now, I do want to clarify because I went down the rabbit hole digging into the science of why this happens, and I guess I want to specify that it is not water vapor, it is condensation. So what you're seeing is there's moisture inside of your exhaust gases, and when the hot gases come out into the cold air, that gas quickly condenses and you can see the water droplets in the air, which is what looks like fog or smoke. So as it dissipates into the air, it basically just disappears, and that is where it turns back into water vapor that's suspended in the atmosphere. So that is completely normal, but you'll see a lot more of it in certain conditions, primarily when you cold start your engine. That's because you'll probably have some condensation inside of your exhaust, which is coming out. You'll also have some of that hot water vapor that's in your exhaust gases, and when it hits the cold air, that will condense and you'll see that smoke as well. But that will eventually go away because as the engine gets hotter, the exhaust gases will get hotter and it will take much colder air for that water to condense. So that's why as the engine warms up, you don't see as much condensation coming out of the exhaust because the exhaust gas is so hot to begin with. The other thing that helps is having a catalytic converter, because the catalytic converter gets extremely hot as it sits right by your exhaust. And so it's going to superheat all of the exhaust gases and keep it hotter as it comes out of your tailpipe. If you don't have a catalytic converter, then you're going to see more condensation coming out of your exhaust because the gases don't get as hot as quickly. So again, especially during cold start and even while the engine is warming up, you can expect to see a lot of that condensation, which translates to looking like smoke. So I just thought that was a little bit of a cool tidbit, you know, as I was digging into it and understanding that it's not water vapor, it's really the condensation that you're seeing. And that's a common thing that a lot of us say. So I guess I just wanted to dig into the semantics here. But yeah, so again, if you're just seeing that smoke come out of your exhaust during a cold start, it will dissipate as it kind of goes up into the atmosphere. You're not really seeing like really thick clouds that are stagnant and sitting in place. Then it is 99.9% chance water vapor. It's very normal when it's cold. When you start up your car in the afternoon, when it warms up, you probably won't see it anymore. And as it warms up going into the spring and summer next year, it's not going to be an issue anymore. So completely normal for the winter months in an area where it gets colder. Now, another type of smoke that you might see is fuel. And while this isn't great, this is also normal, especially for certain setups. What you might see is when you first floor it, you see a puff of smoke, or right when you let off, you might see a slight puff of smoke. This typically looks really dark, like black and hazy. It's not going to be white or bluish. So that gives you a good indication that it is most likely fuel. And obviously, if you're behind the car, you should be able to smell it as fuel as well. Now, this is mostly common when you have auxiliary fueling. So if you have port injection or something that might lag a little bit, might take a second to turn on or a second to turn off, you might see those puffs of smoke just because you have extra unburnt fuel coming out of your exhaust. Also, depending on the scenario, when you first floor it, the car can go into an enrichment period where it puts extra fuel into your combustion chamber just to make sure that it's all ready and safe to do what you're demanding of the car when you put your foot to the floor. So again, you might see a little bit of a puff of smoke, or when your car downshifts, it might puff out smoke. That is completely normal or typical depending on your setup. Now let's talk about the bad smoke, and the main one most people are concerned about is seeing oil. So when oil is burning, it comes out of your exhaust as well, and it comes out as really thick smoke. It will look stagnant, it won't dissipate easily. Whereas when you have moisture and condensation coming out of your exhaust, it typically goes up and just disappears relatively quickly. With oil, it's not going to evaporate, it's going to stay in the air for a long time, especially if you're in an enclosed area, like if you're cold starting your car in your garage, the condensation just kind of disappears. But if it was oil, it would just fill up your garage with smoke. It really just hangs in the air a lot more. And so that's something that's going to indicate pretty easily that you have an issue. It could be your valve cover or your PCV, like we've talked about in previous videos. It also could potentially come from things like your turbo. If your turbo is damaged, then it will create oil. And usually I see that when people do a pull, you see like smoke come out of the exhaust. And usually it's white, thick smoke with a slight bluish tint to it. That will also tell you that it is smoke as well. So that can potentially happen. And then, of course, worst case scenario is if your engine is damaged. So if you've got a damaged piston ring or a ringland that's damaged, when your car is idling, it'll look like a train and just big, thick clouds of smoke will come out. Again, that pretty much indicates that it is coming from oil. Now, another potential cause for smoke is coolant, and this will also kind of look like oil, but the smoke is typically much thicker and you will be able to smell it. It kind of has a sweet smell because it's burning coolant. So that's the easiest way to tell that it's not oil. Oil will be a little bit thinner. It'll hang in the air, but it'll have that bluish tint. And if it's coolant, it will be extremely thick and literally look like the clouds you see up in the sky. Now, the most common cause for this is like a damaged head gasket or potentially a leak in your intercooler. So if your intercooler is leaking, it will push the coolant into your combustion chamber and then burn that, and it'll come out of your exhaust. So you'll see that as well, but it really just depends on what your circumstances are. So it's hard to diagnose in a lot of cases. The easiest thing to do is pressure test your system to see if you can identify any potential coolant leaks. And if you can't find any external coolant leaks, but your pressure or your vacuum levels are dropping, then there's a chance that there's an intercooler issue causing coolant to get pushed into your combustion chamber. You can also do a leak down test, and that will make sure that your combustion chamber is completely sealed up. If the leak down test fails, again, it could potentially be something like a head gasket, because if your head gasket fails, it basically can create a small channel where coolant can go from the coolant passages into your combustion chamber and again get burnt and come out of your exhaust. Now, the last one and probably worst case scenario is fire. So if you have fire coming out of your exhaust, that is a lot of times a bad thing. I know some of you guys do this deliberately, but big, thick black clouds of smoke is pretty much something that is associated with fire or burning a lot of fuel, which can create a really bad time. Now, yes, this can be a result of like a flame tune or anti-lag and stuff like that. If you're, you know, holding it for too long, you'll start seeing puffs of black smoke come out of the car. But if it's really thick, it's pretty much an immediate cause for concern. And I would recommend if you're driving, pull over immediately. Hopefully you have a fire extinguisher or something that can help put it out, and just get out of the car and get to somewhere safe. Now, this looks very different from smoke that's caused by oil and coolant and stuff like that, because again, it is black. I've seen a lot of people get concerned with white smoke thinking that it is, you know, something related to a fire. But if it's white, that's not something that's going to be a cause for concern in that regard. If it's smoke that's coming from a fire, or again, fuel that's just burning out of control, it's going to be completely black and really thick, and you'll notice the difference for sure. So yeah, hopefully this helps you guys out. Again, 99.99999% of you are just experiencing condensation coming out of your exhaust. It is a normal byproduct of the combustion process, and it is something that you will see every winter in certain regions where it gets cold enough. So don't be too scared of that. Just keep an eye on it. Again, if it gets thicker, if it starts to hang, that's when you would probably start digging into other things, if it's, you know, a PCV or valve cover issue or something like that. But most times it's depth. Most times we're just annoying each other by asking the same questions every winter. So yeah, I think that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below.